Wellens syndrome. It was first described in 1982 by Deswan, Barr, and Wellens. They found that in patients with unstable angina who had the characteristic T-wave changes were at high risk for the development of an extensive anterior wall myocardial infarction. The ECG changes were associated with critical stenosis of the proximal left anterior descending coronary artery. The syndrome criteria includes the characteristic T-wave changes in the precordial leads V2 and V3. It may extend from V1 to V6 also. The most common type is the deep inverted T-wave. It is seen in 75% of cases. And the less common type is biphasic T-wave, which is seen in 25% of cases. Let's discuss the diagnostic criteria of Wellens syndrome with an example. This patient presented with history of angina. This ECG was taken during the pain-free period. It shows biphasic T-wave in the precordial leads V2 and V3. It should be noted that there are no Q-waves in the precordial leads. The ST segment is also not elevated, and there is preserved precordial R-wave progression. The patient also had normal serum cardiac marker, namely troponin I in this case. The diagnosis of Wellens syndrome mandates coronary angiogram. It was performed, and it showed critical proximal left anterior descending artery stenosis. In order to prevent extensive anterior wall myocardial infarction, the patient underwent a successful surgical coronary revascularization. Thanks for watching. Hope it was helpful. See you soon in the next video.